Austin's Quay, and George Webb's print shop and George Webb bookseller. I think I'll wander over and have a look at the books. I suppose it's true to say that I built up my library here with second-hand books and the far side of the Dublin bookshop. There's Seamus O'Sullivan's book, The Rolls and Bottles. So Seamus stood here himself, as did W.B. Yeats, as did George Bernard Shaw, Sean O'Casey, Padraig Pearse, James Connolly, Joseph Mary Plunkett, Kettle, all the great writers, poets and patriots and scholars. There's a nice one, Maud Gonne McBride, a biography of Yeats' beloved. But she didn't marry Yeats, she married Major John McBride, who was executed in 1916. And Maud Gonne gave a lifetime of service to the cause of Irish freedom. Musical Illusions by James Joyce. And here's a nice one, The Irish Volunteers. There's a nice bit in this by Padraig Pearse about the true flag of Ireland. The authorised flag is a plain gold harp on a green ground, and no other flag except authorised regimental colours is to be carried by the volunteers. The green background and the gold harp, the old ancient flag of Ireland before the green, white and orange tricolour. Here's a guide to Finnegan's Wake. I suppose you would need another guide. They're all Joyce nowadays. But should you know, if you were to tell the truth, there was only two people understood Finnegan's Wake. James Joyce and myself. And sure, James Joyce is dead.